Hello everyone. Today we have to discuss about transgression process. These are the learning objective of today's lecture. First of all, understand about transgression process, mechanism of transgression, factors affecting transgression, and physiological importance of transgression. And lecture overview are: transpiration is the process of water movement through a plant and its evaporation from aerial parts such as leaves, stems, and flowers. Okay, and water, we know that it is essential for plants, but only a small amount of water taken up by the roots is used for growth, development, and metabolism for the plants. And the remaining 97 to 99.5% is lost by transpiration and gustation. Okay. So first of all, what is transpiration? Okay. So transpiration word we have heard several times. Okay. As you know that plants evaporate water molecule. Okay. So this evaporation of a water molecule from the surface of plant, okay, is called transpiration. Okay, particularly in case of plants, okay, when the plant evaporate the water molecule from their surface, then the term is transpiration. Okay, but if this process occur at any other surface, okay, like any other surface other than plant surface, then the term used only evaporation. Okay, so this is the difference between the transpiration and evaporation. Okay, so first of all, these things we need to understand. Okay, so now the physiological process. So this is a physiological process. Okay, because this is not a simple process that you put water in a certain vessel, then due to heat or sunlight, water evaporate. Okay, this is not this kind of process. Okay, this is a physiological process. Okay, which has certain mechanism. Okay. So that's why the transpiration is physiological process, okay, by which the excess water is lost from the living tissue of plant. Okay, because plant continuously absorb water from the soil. Okay, that's why the plant didn't need that much amount of water. Okay, so the extra water which present in the tissues like stem or leaves become evaporate. Okay, and this process is called transpiration. Okay. And transpiration is the process of water movement through a plant and its evaporation from aerial part. Aerial part means the part which is present in the air. Okay, like green part or even stem or leaves. Okay, so these aerial part have a tendency to evaporate water from their surface. Okay. And the transpiration is the process by which water vapor leaves the living plant body and enter into the atmosphere. Okay, so so any means you can define the transpiration. Okay, so overall it is a physiological process by which the plant tissue has an excess water, and this water can evaporate through the plant. Okay, so this is called transpiration. Okay. Like in this figure, you have to observe that this is a leaf which contain stomata, and this is stem, and this is root. Okay, water absorbed by the root. Okay, and through the leaves, because leaves contain certain types of pores which is called stomata. Okay, so when the stomata open for the photosynthesis, okay, for the exchange of gases. So at the same time, the water molecule evaporate. Okay, and this process is called evaporation. Oh, sorry, this process is called transpiration. Okay. Now, what are the characteristics of transpiration? Okay. So according to recent studies which has been carried out, has been observed that about 10% of the moisture found in the atmosphere is released by the plant through transpiration. Okay, think about that. Okay, you know that atmosphere has humidity. Okay, there is moisture present in the atmosphere, but on an average 10% of this moisture comes from the प्लांट ट्रांसपिरेशन ओके 10% ओके एंड द रिमेनिंग 90% इज मेनली सप्लाइड बाय द इवेपोरेशन फ्रॉम ओशन सी लेक्स रिवर एंड स्ट्रीम ओके एंड द 90% ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ द मॉइस्चर कम फ्रॉम एनी अदर सोर्स लाइक इवेपोरेशन फ्रॉम एनी सरफेस व्हिच हैज वाटर ओके and during a dry period transpiration increase the loss of water in the upper layer of the soil okay you know that okay and which affect vegetation horticulture and agronomic field crops okay because in the during the dry day you know that soil has less water okay and the water become lost through the transpiration okay and plant transpiration is pretty much as an invisible process okay it can't be visible by the naked eye it will be invisible process okay water vapor evaporate and this evaporation we can't observe by the naked eye okay and the transpiration is the evaporation of water from plants and trees okay even any plant okay either it will be herbaceous plant it will be any kind of plant higher plant trees large trees all the plants has transpiration okay and approximately 90% of all water taken up by the plant is lost to through the transpiration okay so this is very much if we think about the water conservation okay so 90% water which plant absorb okay it lost through the transpiration okay so you see that only 10% of water utilized by the plant okay 90% evaporate as a transpiration okay so see when the traditional way of watering to the field okay so in the traditional way more than 90% water evaporate from the surface of the soil okay and when the water absorb this part of this water okay and out of this absorbed part okay approximately 90% water lost through the transpiration okay so this is very much wasteful process if we think about the water that present or utilized by the plant okay and transpiration is the final step in a continuous water pathway that starts from the soil okay you you and we have to discuss in the last lecture that is ascent of sap okay through the ascent of sap the water flow from root to the higher part of the plant okay and there is various mechanism is there okay how the water flow from the root to the top of the plant okay so this continuous column okay so if we think about that the continuous column of flow of water okay in this process okay even in the ascent of sap the final step is transpiration okay so when the root is absorbed water it so it move through the stem then it goes to the leaves then ultimately it evaporate through the leaves okay so so you see that it is the final and last step in the process of transport of water okay and 90% of the plant energy is used in the work of transpiration okay so see that it is a very much wasteful process if we think about the energy conservation so approximately 90% of the energy of the plant which the plant collect through the photosynthesis okay is waste in the process of transpiration okay and transpiration rate are highest in the leaves okay because there are some part of the transpiration also carried by the stem okay so the majority of the part of transpiration carried by the leaves okay because leaves has a stomata okay and transpiration is an elegant sustainable natural design there to perform its vital function without electricity without fossil fuel and without moving part okay so it is a sustainable natural process that carried by the plant okay it doesn't need any electricity any fossil fuel okay even it is automatically processed which carried by the plant it's their own uses of energy okay in the form of ATP and many xeric plant. Xeric plant is xerophyte plant which present in the dry field like in the desert. Okay, so these xeric plant have small leaves. Okay, and silvery reflective leaves. Okay, and hairy leaves. Okay, and produce essential oil, which are all strategies to reduce transpiration by reducing evaporation. Okay, we can in the field of plant where the xerophyte plant are present, like in the desert or in the semi-arid region, there is already scarcity of water is there. Okay, so that's why the plant need to be conserved water. Okay, so how they conserve water? Either they have small leaves, okay, either they have silvery reflective leaves, either they have hairy leaves, either they have essential oil, okay, which contribute to the reduction of transpiration process. Okay, and now importance of transpiration. Okay, so what are the importance of transpiration? So transpiration is a very useful process for plants. Okay, so how this process is useful for the plant? Okay, because it creates negative pressure gradient. Okay, that help draw water and mineral up through the plant from its root. Okay, so it creates negative pressure gradient. Okay, so negative pressure gradient means generally water potential is zero. Okay, so when the water evaporates, it creates a transpiration pull. Okay, so due to the transpiration pull or negative pressure gradient, it help to continuous supply of water throughout the plant. Okay, so in that way it is useful. Okay, because when the water evaporates, it induces transpiration pull that help transport water into the plant. Okay, to a certain height. Okay, and second thing is that it helps to keep the plant cool on hot weather. Okay, so when the water evaporates from the surface of plant, it leaves a cooling effect. Okay, and this due to this cooling effect. Okay, because you know that when the any surface of which has a water, when the this water evaporates, the surface become cool. Okay, like when the sweating it take place on the body. Okay, so when this sweat is evaporate, okay, it will lead to the cooling effect. Okay, same thing apply here. Okay, and it support photosynthesis and encourage the exchange of gases. Okay, that helps maintain level of carbon dioxide and level of oxygen in the atmosphere. Okay, so there are three functions. Okay, the first is transpiration pull, second is cooling effect, third is support photosynthesis. Okay, so due to that function, the transpiration is useful for the plant. Okay, and it also plays a significant part in global hydrological cycle. Okay, you know that there are various cycles continuously running in the atmosphere, like carbon cycle, okay, sulfur cycle. Okay, so in that way there is a oxygen cycle, carbon dioxide cycle. Okay, so in the same way there is a water cycle or hydrological cycle. Okay, so the plant transpiration also contribute to the completing water cycle in the atmosphere. Okay, and release approximately 10% of water back to its environment. Okay, and produce 90 to 450 kg of water for each pound of solid material produced by the plant. Okay, and it creates water vapor that form into fog and clouds. Okay, so this is also the significance of transpiration. And transpiration is also the reason why there is high humidity in places with lots of vegetation cover. Okay, and transpiration through plant stomata is the main pathway for water entering the atmosphere over land. Okay, and to a water resource person, transpiration is considered a loss to the watershed. Okay, so for the person who work on the conservation of water resources, okay, so for that person this transpiration considered as a loss to the watershed. Okay, because when the water present in the soil, it continuously goes up and evaporate by the process of transpiration. And if plant could somehow use less water, the amount saved would remain on the ground to increase recharge. Okay, अगर ऐसा नहीं होता, okay, so ये वाटर क्या हो सकता था, सेव हो सकता था फॉर द फ्यूचरिस्टिक यूजेस बाय द प्लांट. ओके, बट दिस कांट बी अकर इन द प्लांट. ओके, इफ द ट्रांसपिरेशन कंटिन्यूअसली अकर इन द प्लांट एंड ड्यूरिंग द हाई टेंपरेचर डेज, ड्यूरिंग द सनी डेज, ड्यूरिंग द समर डेज, द वाटर इवेपोरेशन और ट्रांसपिरेशन रेट बिकम हाई. ओके, so now the next question arises here, the types of transpiration. Okay, there are three major types of transpiration is there. So on the basis of passage through which plant gives out water in the form of vapor transpiration. Okay, yani kis parts se water evaporate ho raha hai, on that basis there are three kind of transpiration. Okay, the first one is stomatal transpiration, which carried by through the stomatal opening. Second, cuticular transpiration, which occur or carried by the cuticle that present at the surface of leaves. Okay, cuticle. Okay, it is a layer on the surface of leaves. And third is lenticular transpiration. Okay, there is a small pore present at the surface of the stem. Okay, which is called a lenticles. Okay, so the third type of transpiration is lenticular transpiration. It occurs through the lenticles. Okay. So through the stomata, term used stomatal transpiration, through the cuticle, term used cuticular transpiration, and through the lenticles, term used lenticular transpiration. Okay. So first one is stomatal transpiration. Okay. So this type of transpiration when the stomata used to evaporate the water molecule. Okay. And this is called stomatal transpiration. And this type of transpiration only occur in its presence of sunlight. Okay. So because when the sunlight is there, photosynthesis is take place. Due to photosynthesis, the stomata needs to open and close, okay, for the exchange of gases. So at the same time, the water molecule evaporates from the leaves. Okay, so that's why it occurs during the sunlight time or day time. Okay, because the stomata open in the presence of sunlight and close in the darkness. Okay, so in this method, plant gives out 80 to 90% water in the form of vapor. Okay, so this is the major types of transpiration that carried by the plants. Okay. So this is a structure of leaves, okay, in which there is a stomatal opening is there. Okay, this is cuticle, cuticle surface of on the leaves. Okay, and the second one is cuticular transpiration. Okay, so at the surface of leaves there is layer of cuticle. Okay, and this is a wax. Okay, which present at the surface of leaves. Okay, and it has a small cut between the layer. It is not a continuous layer. It may have certain cuts. Okay, so transpiration that occurs through the cuticle or crack of thin cuticle layer. Okay, so because if certain part in cuticle become break, this so water evaporates from this side. And this is a day-night process. Okay, so through the cuticle, the transpiration either carried during the daytime and either carried during the night time. Okay, so in this process, approximately 5 to 10% water is given out in the form of water vapor. Okay, so this is a second type of transpiration. Now third one is lenticular transpiration. Okay, you have to see in the figure. This is lenticles that present at the surface of stem. Okay, in the figure of lower side, this is a large figure in which you have to see that how the lenticles are present. Okay, this is a small cut which present deep inside the stem. Okay, so so that the inner epidermis can expose to the atmosphere. So sometimes transpiration occurs through lenticles, and this small crack that present at the surface of stem is called lenticles. Okay. So if the transpiration carried through the lenticles, the term used lenticular transpiration. Okay. And the small opening in the corky tissue covering stem and tube. Okay. जो stem है और जो tube है, जो branches है. And this type of transpiration is said to be lenticular transpiration. Okay, but it is insignificant as compared to stomatal transpiration. Okay, so only the 0.1% water given off or evaporate in the form of water vapor through the lenticles. Okay, so these are the three kind of transpiration. Okay. So in this figure you have to see that the aerial part of the whole plant, which has either stomata, either cuticle, either lenticles. Okay, but more than approximately 90% of the water evaporates through the stomata. Or you also say that 90% transpiration carried by the stomata, and approximately 3 to 10% transpiration carried by the cuticle. And only 0.1% of the transpiration carried by the lenticles. Okay. So, think about that. What are the difference between the transpiration and evaporation? Because both are the similar process in terms of the water evaporation. क्योंकि दोनों में ही water evaporate हो रहा है. Okay. But what is the difference between them? So transpiration is a physiological process which occur only in the plant. Okay, but evaporation is a physical process, not physiological. Physical process in any free surface water can evaporate. Okay, and transpiration means the water raised by the plant in the air. Okay, so this is only kind process. Okay, which occur in the plant. And evaporation means the conversion of liquid into the vapor from any surface, from the any system. Okay, and water moves through the epidermis with its cuticle or through the stomata or lenticles that present on the stem. Okay, so only the thick way through which the water can evaporate in the transpiration. Okay, but evaporation occur at any surface. Okay, any liquid surface. Okay, so the living epidermis and stomata are not involved in the process of evaporation. Okay, because it is not a physiological process, it is a process, only physical process. Okay, it can occur on the non-living surface. Okay, and living cells are involved in this process. Okay, but evaporation, not much force are involved. Okay, so non-living surface can evaporate. And living force such as vapor pressure, osmotic pressure are involved in the process of transpiration. Okay, and the evaporation need not much forces. Okay, it is just evaporation from the water surface. Okay, and formation of vapor continue for some time even after the saturation of outside air. Okay. So it doesn't mean when the saturation is higher, okay, the transpiration becomes stop. Okay, it can't happen in the process of transpiration. Transpiration until continue when there is a saturation in the air. Okay, and it continues as long as water is available on the surface in case of evaporation. Okay, it is largely depend upon absorption. Okay. हुमेरा बेटा नाउ इट इज अ रेगुलेटेड प्रोसेस. ओके, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज अ रेगुलेटेड प्रोसेस एंड इट इज नॉन रेगुलेटेड प्रोसेस. ओके, एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज कंपैरेटिवली स्लो प्रोसेस एंड इवोपरेशन इज अ फास्टर प्रोसेस. ओके, एंड वाटर वेपर आर फॉर्म्ड इन द इंटरनल टिश्यू ऑफ द प्लांट इन केस ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. And water vapor are formed at the free surface of the water in case of evaporation. Okay, so these are the some basic difference between the transpiration and the evaporation. Okay, both processes are very distinct. Okay, but only same thing occur here, the evaporation of water. Now, what are the mechanism of transpiration? Okay. water is passively transported into the root, okay, and then it enters into the xylem tissue, and the force of cohesion and adhesion cause the water molecule to form a water column in the xylem. Okay, this is process called ascent of cell, and water moves from the xylem into the mesophyll cells of the leaves, okay, and evaporate from their surface and leaves the plant by diffusion through the stomata. Okay, and the process by which the water evaporates from the mesophyll cells is the diffusion. Okay, diffusion means the flow of water from the higher to the lower concentration, because leaves has a higher concentration of water as compared to the atmosphere. So water leaves the mesophyll cells, okay, and this process is called transpiration. Okay, and the types of transport is diffusion, and the transpiration involves three basic steps. Okay, so first of all, absorption of water from the root. Okay, this is the first step. Then capillary action in the xylem vessels. Okay, and the ascent of sap, or the flow of water in the form of water column through the xylem tissue of the stem. Okay, then finally evaporation at the leaf surface. Okay, so these are the three basic steps that involve in the transpiration. Okay, so first of all, root absorb water from the soil through osmosis. Okay, so you know that what is the osmosis. Okay, so osmosis is the flow of water from the lower concentration to the higher concentration solution. Okay, so in this process, water travels from the high concentration area to a low concentration area. Okay, in case of water. Okay, so the surface where water the high concentration of water represent, or in terms of solution we say that low concentration. Obviously, when the water is large amount, the solution is less concentrated. Okay, if water is less amount, the solution is high concentrated. Okay, so think about that. If we have 10 ml water containing 1 gram sugar, and in another vessel we have 100 ml water containing 1 gram of sugar. Okay, so the 1 gram sugar present in the 10 ml water is has higher concentration, and 1 gram sugar that present in the 100 ml water is a dilute solution. Okay, but if we compare the water, so the water quantity water has present large amount in the dilute solution and less amount in the concentrated solution. Okay, so in terms of water travels from the high concentration area to the low concentration area via semi permeable membrane. Okay, so you have to see in this figure that is no water concentration outside the cell. Okay, and at that time water leaves the cell. Okay, so this cell. Okay, so if this condition would occur, the cell become shrink. Okay, and at that time the term used plasmolyzed. Okay, so this cell is under plasmolysis. Okay, for plasmolyzed condition. Okay, and when the equal water concentration inside and outside. Okay, so at that time the water flow in and flow out become in equilibrium. Okay, so at that time the term used flaccid. Okay, and if high water concentration outside the cell. Okay, so at that time the water entered into the cell. Okay, and at this time the cell become full of water, and the term used turgid. Okay, so there is three condition is possible in the plant. First is plasmolyzed condition, and second is flaccid condition, and third is a turgid condition. Okay, so cell water concentration is lower as compared to the soil water concentration as a normal case. Okay. Now why not soil molecule enter into the cell? Okay. So first thing is that the soil particle has a large size which cannot enter through the membrane size, okay, because this is a semi-permeable membrane and it can only pass the water molecule. Okay. So there is two kind of transport is there. There is active and passive. Okay, so this is already we have to discuss. Okay, in the previous class, what is the active transport and what is the passive transport? This is only the basis of the utilization of the energy. Okay. And then next thing is that the root surface has thousands of tiny root hairs. Okay. Which provide or enhance the surface area of the root. Okay, so that's why the water has a high area to enter into the root. Okay, so due to presence of these root hair, the greater volume and greater surface area, and therefore the more osmosis take place through which the large amount of water can enter into the root. Okay, so this is the function of root hair that present on the surface of root. Okay, it contribute the absorption of water. Okay, because the transpiration process start from the absorption of water through the root. Okay. And what is the turgor pressure? Turgor pressure exerted by fluid in a cell that presses the cell membrane against the cell wall. Okay, so when the water entered into the cell, okay, the cell become turgid. Okay, and the force the force that due to the increased quantity of water inside the cell. Okay, so this is called turgor pressure. Okay, so the turgor is what make living plant tissue rigid. Okay, due to this turgor pressure, the plant can able to stand. Okay, because you have to observe that sometimes the plant did not have much water. Okay, so at that time the plant leaves become flaccid. Okay, wo kya ho jata hai, sikud jate hain. Okay, kyunki isme water proper quantity mein present nahi hota hai. Okay, so loss of turgor resulting from the loss of water from plant cell cause flower and leaves to be wilt. Okay, aur jo ye leaves sikud jate hain, so for this the term use wilt. Okay, and this process is called wilting. Okay, when the sufficient quantity of water and not present in the soil, so that the plant can't able to absorb the sufficient quantity of water and did not maintain their turgidity, so the plant become flaccid, and the term used wilting. Okay, so you have to see that this is a normal turgid plant and this is a plant after wilting. Okay, so this is turgid cell and this is flaccid cell. Okay, so this is the difference between. Okay, so excess transpiration cause mesophyll cell to become flaccid. Jab zyada transpiration hoga to cell kaisi ho jayegi, flaccid ho jayegi. Okay, and transpiration cause or induce transpiration pool that help to continuous flow of water from the root to the higher or top part of the plant. Okay, even water can flow 100 of height, 100 feet of height toward the plant. Okay, and capillary action. Okay, so this is also contribute to the continuous flow of water into the stem. Okay, and ultimately the ending of this continuous flow of water and the end process of this flow of water into the plant is transpiration. Okay, this capillary action can be maintained by the two forces that present in the water molecule. The first is adhesion and second is cohesion. Okay, and both these forces are due to the water molecule. Okay, and adhesion occur when water forms hydrogen bond with the xylem cell wall, and cohesion occur when water molecule hydrogen bond with each other. Okay, and cohesion between water molecule create a water chain effect. Okay. So both two process, that is adhesion and cohesion, contribute to the continuous flow of water in the plant. Okay. So finally, water evaporates from the surface of leaves. Okay, and this process is called transpiration. Okay. And molecules move from higher concentration to lower concentration, and this process is called diffusion. Okay, so the process or type of transport that occur in the leaves, mesophyll cells, is called diffusion. Okay, and when internal vapor pressure is more than atmospheric pressure, okay, so this also contributes to the increased transpiration rate. Okay. Now the term water potential. Okay, so water potential quantifies the tendency of free water to move from one area to another due to osmosis, gravity, mechanical pressure, or matrix effect such as surface tension. Okay, so ये जो water potential है, okay, it can be calculated. Okay. So how this water potential can be calculated? Okay, so water potential can be calculated by the pressure potential. Okay, it means the potential in the water due to the pressure. Okay, and the solute potential. Okay, so the change in the potential of water due to the presence of certain quantity of solute. Okay. So both contribute to the water potential, either pressure potential and solute potential. Okay, so you have to see that in this figure, the pure water has water potential zero. Okay, but salty water has negative water potential. Okay, that is -150. Okay, then highly salty water has highly negative water potential. For example, this water which has high which is highly salty has -250 water potential. Okay, so so you have to see that how the water potential changes. Okay, so if the quantity of solute increase in the water, it decrease water potential. Okay, and water flow from always higher water potential to the lower water potential. Okay, so when we separate these two liquid from the semi permeable membrane, water flow from the first vessel toward the second vessel, because water always flow from the higher water potential toward the lower water potential until the water potential of the both the side of the water become equal. Okay, so osmosis take place due to the difference in the water potential. Okay, so the water potential mein difference hota hai, tabhi kya hota hai, osmosis hota hai. Okay, so you have to see that in this figure, when we have a 0.4 molar sucrose solution. Okay, so at that time the water potential is -0.9. okay, because this solution has pressure potential zero and solute potential -0.9. okay, when we add this value, the water potential of this solution become -0.9. okay, now when the cell become flaccid, okay, so at that time the water pressure potential is already zero, and the solute potential become decrease. Okay, so it it become -0.7. okay, so at this time resultant solute resultant water potential is minus 0.7. okay, so you have to see there how the solute concentration affect the water potential. Okay, so when the high quantity of salt is present, the water potential decrease. Okay, and water always flow from high water potential toward the low water potential. Okay, so after certain time, this cell water potential become changed. Okay, to point minus 0.9 to minus 0.7 after certain time. Now the next part of this discussion is what are the adaptation toward the decrease rate of transpiration. Okay, and kya adaptation hote hain jisse water ka evaporation aur transpiration ki rate kya hoti hai, kam hoti hai. Okay, so in the xerophyte plant there is lack of water in the soil. Okay, we already know that because these plant present in the desert and it has reduced the number of leaves. Okay, iske leaves bhi kam hote hain and turn the leaves into the spine like this. Okay, and it has less number of stomata, so that rate of transpiration become reduced. Okay, for example cactus. Okay, it is a xerophyte plant which has adaptation to decrease rate of transpiration. Okay, and there is another types of adaptation that present in the mountain plants. Okay, because in the plant that present in the mountain. Okay, because mountain has high atmosphere, mountain has decreased atmospheric pressure. Okay, any mountain mein kya hota hai, atmospheric pressure decrease ho jata hai, that's why evaporation increase at the mountain. Okay, so that's why the transpiration rate increase in the plant that present at the higher altitude. Okay, yani jo plant higher altitude par present hote hain unme transpiration kya hota hai, zyada hota hai. Okay, and the plant which present at the cold climatic condition. Okay, so due to the shedding of the leaves, it will reduce the transpiration. Okay, because deciduous trees shed twice a year. Okay, jab leaves hi nahi hoga to obviously transpiration kya hoga, kam hoga. Okay, so in the cold climate there is reduced transpiration is there. And in a cold climate and evergreen tree, okay, so the reduced surface area of leaves. Okay, in the cold climate you have to see that this is a tree or pine tree. Okay, and decrease surface area into needle like structure. Okay, yani leaves kaisa hota hai, needle like hota hai, so that's the stomata number is less. Okay, ultimately it helps to reduce transpiration. Okay, for example pine tree that present in the hill area. Okay, and the plant that present in the equatorial or which are equatorial evergreen. Okay, like the banana, so it has a bigger leaves and big surface and lot of stomata, and it has a thick waxy layer known as cuticle. Okay, and cuticle cover the stomatal opening in the epidermis that prevent excess loss of water through transpiration. Okay, so this adaptation present in the equatorial evergreen plants. Okay, like banana, and some plant that have not having waxy layer having sunken stomata. This is another kind of adaptation which helps to reduce your transpiration. Okay, and it is covered with lots of hair, and fine fibrous structure covers the stomatal opening and traps the vapor that comes out to the stomata, and humidity increase into it, and ultimately it reduce transpiration due to the sunken stomata, and these stomata cover with the lots of hair. Okay, so this is another adaptation in the plant which did not have cuticle at their surface. Okay, and next part of this is measurement of transpiration. Okay, how we can measure the rate of transpiration in the plants? Okay, so Stephen Hales devised three method for measuring the rate of transpiration. The first way to transpiration rate measurement is by weighing potted plant, second by potometer, and third by measuring the humidity of air. Okay, so these are the three method by which we can calculate the transpiration rate. Okay, so by weighing potted plant, we have to calculate the transpiration rate. Okay, because when the transpiration occur, it loses the water. Okay, so definitely certain amount of weight become reduced. Okay, so in that way we have to observe the rate of transpiration. Okay, so with the time, how much weight of plant decrease. Okay, so that we can calculate the rate of transpiration on the basis of these data. Okay, and the second method is by the photometer. Okay, obviously when the transpiration is take place, it create a transpiration pool. Okay, and due to the transpiration pool, we have to set up this kind of experiment. Okay, in which you have to see that there is air bubble that present in the water column. Okay, in the capillary tube. Okay, if transpiration occur, this water, this air bubble move toward the side of the movement of water. Okay, so on that basis, on the measurement of distance with a particular time frame, we have to calculate the rate of transpiration. Okay, and the third way to measuring the rate of transpiration is the third method is by measuring the humidity of air. Okay, so obviously when the transpiration occurs through the plant, obviously it the atmosphere or control environment, okay, at which we have to carry out our experiment become humid. Okay, so the increase humidity level with the time frame, we have to calculate the rate of transpiration. Okay, and now what are the factors which contribute to the affect the rate of transpiration? Okay, so there are certain factors which affect the rate of transpiration. Means there are certain factors which contribute to the increased rate of transpiration, there are certain factors which decrease the rate of transpiration. Okay, so what are these factors? So there are two kind of factors. So first is plant parameter itself, and second is environmental condition. Okay, so plant factor like stomata, number of stomata, number of leaves affect the rate of transpiration. Okay, and cuticle, leaf area, root and shoot ratio also affect the rate of transpiration. Okay, and mesophyll cells and leaf modification also affect the rate of transpiration. Okay, if we talk about the environmental condition, so light intensity also affect the rate of transpiration. Okay, when the light intensity increase, the rate of transpiration also increase. Okay, and humid environment. Okay, when the humidity increase, the rate of transpiration decrease. Okay, temperature, when the temperature increase, rate of transpiration increase. Okay, wind, when the wind speed increase, the rate of transpiration increase. Okay, fine. So Josila?
Yes sir.
Any doubt in the transpiration?
No sir, they will be fine if I go through.
Okay. So you have to revise the content. Okay, and if you have any doubt, you can discuss with me. Okay. Vijeta?
Okay sir.
Vijeta? Okay, so fine, okay. Thank you. हाँ Vijeta, कहाँ हो? Transpiration क्या होता है बताइए, ट्रांसपिरेशन क्या होता है?
ट्रांसपिरेशन वो होता है जो आ, आ, पत्ती